Bonjour everyone, Pentouf here today for a new video in which we have the pleasure of reviewing the Super Conqueror simply because Wargaming decided all of a sudden to put it in the shop for two offers, one at 25,000 gold and the second one at 20,000 gold. Main difference between both of them is that this one features an order for you to get 5 mystery boxes plus the legendary camouflage plus a cool avatar, whereas the other only features the Super Conqueror vanilla. And to be fair, this tank you're seeing right there is probably one of my favorite tier 10 ever, simply because it features everything you need in order for you to be effective on the battlefield. The strongest turret armor ever, simply because you literally have no weak spots. Even that cupola right there is not a weak spot, featuring more than 310mm of armor. On top of that, spaced armor pretty much everywhere, on the upper part of the hull, also on the side of the turret. And of course, when you have that much armor already mounted on the tank, plus some 20mm spaced armor on the sides, well, let's say that you are nearly indestructible in all down. Now you still have the little weak spot, which is the lower part of the hull, but do not mind it, simply because it's so small that if you manage to just put something like a rock or so on this part and just show the upper part of the hull, even with gold shell, people will not penetrate. For the rest of the statistics, we should talk about the gun, which is one of the greatest as well, except for the aim time, that is only 4.1 seconds. And the problem with such an aim time is that it's slow. And the fact that it's slow makes you lose, or at least miss, a lot of shells. 0.32 of gun dispersion, that doesn't help at all, knowing the Chieftain is a much better one, sitting at 0.30 or something like that. But to compensate for it, you have 2.8k DPM, which is really wild for tier 10 heavy. 8.5 seconds of reload, 260 average penetration, 326 with your gold shell, 400 alpha damage per shot. And on top of that, the high explosive penetration that sits at 110mm, allowing you to sneak a lot of HE on pretty much every single target as long as you see their sight. And trust me, it's gonna make a difference because you have 515 alpha damage with it. On top of that, 10 degrees of gun depression, allowing you to work with your turret armor beautifully, because as long as you're in all down and using those 10 degrees, you are literally impenetrable. Probably the biggest downside of the Super Conqueror would be its mobility, because of course, as you're a conqueror that we mounted a lot of spaced armor on, you are slow. You only go to 30, 36 kilometers per hour, depending if you're rushing down a hill or not, which is going to be a little bit upsetting most of the time, because your average speed, as you can see, is 29 per kilometers per hour. Now for the equipments, let's say that things are getting a little bit spicy. First I go for the gun rammer because my penetration is enough, and then it's gun lane drive to reduce my aim time. To finish off with the refined gun, because without this equipment, your gun accuracy is just terrible and your dispersion is out of the norm. And this is something you want to avoid, so yeah, try to take the refined gun as much as you can on your Super Conqueror. On the vitality part, I go for the defense system because I'm not gonna ram anyone. Sitting next to it, enhanced armor, because you need to increase that armor that is already great in order to be 100% sure that tank destroyers with gold shell will not be able to penetrate you. Finally, toolbox because an track is useless, improved optics because I'm not gonna camp, engine accelerator because my mobility sucks, so I would like to increase it just a little bit, even if it's only 1 km/h. Finishing off with high-end consumable, because as you're using adrenaline, you wanna use it as long as possible, because with 8.5 seconds of reload, trust me, you're gonna use it quite a lot. Not to mention the crazy camo Wargaming put on it. It's just amazing. It looks beautiful, in my opinion. It looks like a superhero, like Superman, and I guess that's what they wanted to tell us, because Super Conqueror, Superman, etc, etc. So that's a cool aspect of the tank. Now comes the time for us to talk about the playstyle, and here let's say that things are getting a little bit interesting, because all you have to do is being in all down. And the fact that this is the only thing you need to do makes it extremely newbie friendly, because even if you're exposing the whole tank, trust me, it's really hard to penetrate you. Let's just imagine I was sitting right there, for example at this position, taking a light tank or so. When I want to sneak a shot on the Conqueror that is right there, I need to aim at that part, which is the lower part of the hull. But shooting at this part, I still have a great chance to shoot at this little upper part of the side armor right there, because this little area where you see the number here is actually impenetrable, and most of the shells that tries to go on the lower part of your hull will shoot this part right there, which prevently allow you to bounce a lot of shells out of nowhere. So it's newbie friendly, So you guess who needs to get this tank. And personally, I think it's a really nice addition to your collection, to your already existing tier 10. Let's say that, in my opinion, it would be the T22 medium of the heavies at tier 10. So yeah, kind of cool to get. And of course, if you are familiar with the Action 10, the Super Conqueror is literally a kind of an Action 10 sitting at tier 10. So, for the rest, guys, let's see what we're doing. For the moment, we're taking an all-down position. You're gonna see if I show you briefly how it looks from the point of view of my opponents. They can see two things, my turret and the upper part of my hull, which is impenetrable. Something to mention also with the Super Conqueror, unlike the other British tanks and heavy tanks, this one can actually side scrape. As long as you don't over angle it, you are safe, which is not the case, for example, with the Russians and especially the Object 52 that you can over angle and not get penetrated at all. So we don't need to move forward. We don't need to move forward and we don't want to move forward. Here I did a mistake by pushing a little bit too far, and obviously it paid off for my opponents that managed to sneak nearly 1k damage straight into me. RIP, but this happens, but I'm not gonna do the mistake again because right now I'm facing the WZ in all down. And as you can see, when you're facing them in all down, they really struggle being able to do whatever. Now you see the mighty 10 degrees of gun depression at work, working perfectly on the WZ. And yeah, as I'm slow, I'm not trying to push forward. As you can see, I'm sticking myself to the back of the team, or at least to the back of the map. For two reasons. The first is that I'm slow, as I just mentioned, but also because I don't need to push. Why would I push if they are all coming one by one? As long as they I have them in my sight range, I'm not gonna bother. So there we go, we're sneaking in another HE on the AV. I told you, 110 millimeters of penetration is way enough to do the job on most of the tanks, and especially glass cannons, such as it's the case with the AV. But there we go, for two shots, killing the boy, and now having to deal with the rest of them. And I see that there is the AV on the other side right there, and I'm gonna say, hey, you know what, let's try my luck. And here, do you know how I managed to pull that off? Because I was using the right equipment. I was using the one that gives you a better gun dispersion when you are immobile. It's extremely important to use it with the Karinov Action 10. Otherwise, those stopping and shooting shots is not gonna work. So there we go, now we only have to deal with the M5U and the 50TP and have a great advantage because I'm over a hill. So I will be able to use that for myself, but unfortunately not being in all down, I'm gonna try to side scrape, not here because here I know that I'm not gonna be able to get penetrated. And now we are going for some side scrape, and you're gonna see how effective it is, because right now by being side scrape, you're gonna see after I sting my shot on the Yo and after he bounced, when you take a look at where the guy managed to penetrate, or at least tried to penetrate, he went here in this exact area. But it's impossible to penetrate me from this position. Just take a look at that. I told you, my guys, the side scrape. As long as you don't show the lower part of your hull and that your side scrape stops at the very first track, you are safe. Nobody can penetrate you, and it will result in them bouncing off. So there we go. Second shot straight in the M6U. Boom. See ya soon. And now, the only thing we have to deal with is the 50TP. And to be fair, it's not the hardest target. It's not the hardest. So there we go. I'm gonna jump off the cliff, trying to get the boy. Unfortunately, I did not catch up as he was rushing the 50TP. So I'm gonna try something else instead. I'm gonna go on the Leo 1, sneaking an HE, because as I told you, with your HE penetration, you can do a lot of things. And now the Yaktarier killed it on, and we are good. We are good. We captured the base and killed all the opponents at the same time. Let's say that it's a glorious victory that got us the first class and high caliber medal. And just take a look at the number of credits we did, because yes, the Carnarvon has the Super Conqueror has that collectible credit coefficient, but it's close to the one you have on a premium, which means that with this tank, even if it's tier 10, you're gonna do a lot of credits, and it's hilarious to play it in a pricing. So hopefully, guys, you enjoyed. If that's the case, feel free to subscribe, like, and share, and I'm gonna see you soon for a new video. Bye.